Ministries, and it's the Center for Spiritual Living. I'll invite you now to stand and sing our opening song.
Woo! Woo! Good morning.
Everyone doing today? Good. All right. Well, it's wonderful to see you all here. Genesis is a community dedicated to love, inspiring harmony, and creating connections to empower spiritual growth. And we are love that you are here to share in that with us today. My name is Dave, and I will be your host this morning. Our online host is Eric. Yes? All right. The great Eric, as I love to say. If this is your first time watching online, please comment on how you found Genesis. And I am also wanting to say I'm going to go off script today because this whole thing is going to be a little bit off script today because we're going to have some fun today here. And I'm just going to say that our usual guest that we're going to have here to say Michael Bogar has come down with COVID. So first of all, I want to say that I am sending very much healing and blessings all to Michael and just knowing that God is working within his spirit right now and healing him in that perfect way, in that perfect path. And so just the first, I wanted to send that out. And so our guest speaker or our guest person today is Karen Williams. And I think that it's kind of perfect that Karen Williams, considering that what Christine S. did 2 months ago, a talk, and then I did a talk last month, and so it's like, Spirit is saying, okay, well, I guess another practitioner needs to come up, so Karen gets to be our speaker today. So Cynthia, Randy, Rose, watch out. Spirit's coming for you, and it's going to get you up on stage here. I'm just telling you. I think that's the way it's going to work. So we're very, very blessed. Karen is a fantastic speaker, and she's going to lead us in a wonderful loving kindness meditation today, and I think that it's an absolutely perfect time for that and for that energy, and so we get to all be a part of the energy and send that out to this world. So thank you so much, Karen, for blessing us with that today. Okay, so with that being said, let us go ahead and read our mission and vision statements. We are building a vibrant community, cultivating a garden of spiritual growth, honoring vulnerability, creating a safe place of comfort and peace where all are welcome and accepted. And our vision. Genesis is a bright beacon with an unshakable heart of love, accepting all, a home for the soul where we each creatively express our spiritual brilliance. Okay, and now we'll go on to our announcements. All right, perfect. So we have the Healers and Hunters men's group hosted by me and our sound guy, Jim Munson. If you want to be a part of that, it's a men's group. We meet every Thursday. Right now we're doing the Spiritual Laws of Success, but we do a lot of connection. We just connect these guys together and we get together. So if you want to be a part of that, come talk to me a part of that and I'll send you Zoom links out. It's a great time and there's a bunch of us who is a part of that.
BYOB, I'm joking.
I was trying to think of like a spiritual thing that I could say, bring your own abundance. Yeah, bring your own Bible. Okay. Thanks for that, Jim. All right. Next. All right. Mental equivalence. Cynthia Zink, our practitioner, is offering the class Mental Equivalence starting Wednesday, July 10th, last Wednesday. If you didn't come last week, you can still join us. Yeah, so it's a five-week class, and Mental Equivalent is kind of getting that mental equivalent of, in your own mind, of what you want to manifest in your own life, and it's a fantastic way to dive deep into the science of mind. This class is a leap into a state of true potential by activating the powerful law of mental equivalence. For everything formed in the universe, there is a corresponding mental image. Moving on, spiritual social justice. If you want information, it's at the welcome table, and just take a few minutes and go check that out. Book studies. Are we doing a book study today, Karen?
Yes.
Okay, great. We're doing a book study today. So Karen's doing double duty today. So good job, Karen. Wow, thank you for that. So after service for day, if you want to read This Thing Called You and dive into that, just drop in. We do it every Sunday when Karen's here.
Or when I'm
not. Or when we're not, and when she's not. That's true.
He's in charge of the book study. We just meet.
We just meet and get together and have a good time, because that's what we do here. That's right. Okay. Is there anyone visiting Genesis for the first time today? Hi. Would you like to introduce yourselves? Michael? Hi, Michael.
My name is Marie.
Hi, Marie. Well, thank you so much for joining us here today. We appreciate that. Is there anyone online?
Nope.
Okay. Well, right now we're going to get our chance to meet our guests today. And so we're going to go up and we're going to meet and greet each other. So we all give up and we love on each other. We hug each other. If you don't want to hug, that's not something you could do. We always know that if you just stick your hand out, we understand that that means you just want to shake your hand. So let's get up, greet, and say hi to each other. All right. Well, I love that time of our service.
Yes.
It's great being able to get up and love and hug each other. So today I want to take just a moment just to give thanks to those in volunteer service today. So our morning greeter is Cynthia. Yay. And there you go. A projector and video, Mike and Eric. On offering, we have Gideon. Our sound tech is Jim Monson. Our online host is Eric. And our musical guest today is Matt and Becky. Let's give thanks to them. And our service practitioner is, it's me. So you get a double duty of Dave today. That's right. So I will be back up on stage and lead us into a little reading and prayer. But for now, we are going to go and to do our centering song.
I breathe and turn within. I breathe and turn within. I open up my heart and feel God's presence. I breathe and turn within. I breathe and turn within.
So today's reading comes from one of my favorite books. It's a Unity book by Gary Simmons, and it's called The Eye of the Storm. And it's about, it says, embracing conflict, creating peace. And I thought to myself, that is an absolutely perfect place to be at today, amongst the conflict, knowing that the eye of us, that the spirit of us, has always got this and can always create peace within. Your soul moves you towards challenges because they stretch you in ways that separate you from falsehoods and dependencies. What you discover is that you are not your experiences, you are greater. The distinction, I am not my experience, is a key principle in discovering your wholeness. Often we use our conditions or situations as evidence of our worth and well-being. I become less or more because of what happens to me. If I lose my job, get sick, or fail in a relationship, or have a minister that gets COVID, add to that one, I may confuse these events with myself. I may become depressed or defeated, yet in truth, I am not my experience. I may be challenged by what happens in my life, but I'm always greater than my challenges. My circumstances may appear limiting or difficult, but I am not bound by external conditions because I am spirit. In spirit, conditions are mental structures. In spirit, limitations are fragmented possibilities. Nothing is an obstacle to spirit because conditions arise in activity of spirit, seeking to catch our attention so that we may discover our true lives in God. And so now I invite us to just go within. And just breathe in. Just take a moment and just breathe in. Breathe in that loving life. Breathe in that divinity. Bring in that wholeness. Bring in that God itself. Breathe in that spirit itself. I just recognize the spirit today as love. I recognize that spirit today as compassion. I recognize that spirit today as kindness. And today I recognize that spirit within us all as peace. I know that these are all the qualities of God. And I recognize that these are all the qualities of wholeness. I recognize that these are all the qualities that are inside each and every single one of us. And so I just realized today that the spirit of us, that the spirit of the love of us, the compassion of us, the love of us, the peace of us, is a spirit that we embrace inside ourselves. And knowing that spirit within inside ourselves, we can send that message out to this world. We have that power within inside us because we are spirit in action. We are spirit in form. We are that truth that this world so desperately needs to hear right now. And so I realize that as we become ourselves, as we send that out into this world, that spirit and the whole world says yes to us. It is magnified by our presence. It is magnified by the divinity of who we are, by the loving kindness that we are, by the energy and compassion that we are right here in this very moment. And so I'm grateful for that truth. I'm grateful for that knowing. I am grateful for this divine community that comes together, that even in the chaos, this community comes together and finds peace. That even in the chaos, this community comes together and finds a way to say yes, to keep moving forward, and to keep saying that the Spirit of God will say yes. And so I'm grateful for Karen. I'm grateful for Karen's message. I'm grateful for Karen stepping up today and giving her divinity, her spirit, her energy, and who she is so that Genesis can feel that beautifulness that she has, that awesomeness, that great spirit energy. And I know that the loving kindness of Karen, because I felt that loving kindness of energy of Karen, that springs forth. And we are all grateful to be basking in that presence. And so with that gratitude, I just give this prayer, I give these words over to that great spirit itself, knowing that spirit only says yes to love, to life, to loving kindness, to peace. Spirit says yes to it all. I give great gratitude into that, knowing that it is so, and so it is. And so with that, Matt and Ben.
See it in your eyes. So pull back the curtain, take off the disguise. Whoever told you you ain't worth the fight? Cross tells a story that'll change your mind. 'Cause there's only love in the heart of God. There's beauty from ashes, so come as you are. There's only love in the heart of God. Oh, 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 oh. step out of the shadows. There's no judgment here. There's only love in the heart of God. No room for shame in these open arms. There's beauty from ashes, so come as you are. There's only love in the heart of God. Oh, head, writing you off, leaving you lost. He's not sitting there shaking his head, wishing he'd never been to that cross. God's not sitting there shaking her head, writing you off, leaving you lost. She's not sitting there shaking her head. She went to that cross. She went to that cross. 'Cause God loves you so.
And Matt, thank you so much. That was perfect. There's only love in the heart of God, and that's kind of where we're going today, because there's a lot of evidence as we look around ourselves of a lack of love, a lack of resources, a lack of compassion, just lack and lack and lack. And so this is one of my favorite spiritual practices, is loving kindness meditation. It's super easy to do, and it's very powerful, because one of the things that we believe as religious scientists is that God is love. And it's not just us that believes that either, right? Like, this is a universal truth, and it might be called different things. Creator, Great Spirit, Brahma, Allah. There's so many names for love, right? There's many names for God as there are people on this planet. There's many names for love as there are people on this planet. And so this is an opportunity for us to remove ourselves from what is happening outside of us and turn our attention to what is happening within us, because this is where we know that the transformation takes place. This is where we move fear into faith. This is where we move hatred into love. This is where we move lack into limitlessness. The nature of God itself is infinite, and so are we. Each of us individually. So I want to take this moment to introduce myself, Karen Williams. I'm a practitioner here at Genesis Center for Spiritual Living. I've been a practitioner for 19 years, and I've been in this teaching for, I've been in this teaching for quite a while. I raised my kids in this teaching because I wanted them to have some sort of spiritual foundation, some sort of grounding, some support. And so they were raised in this teaching. They no longer attend a Center for Spiritual Living Church, but I don't take that personally, because I know that there's this transition period for young people when they become 18 and they're kind of out of the teen youth group, that they don't feel like they belong in this big adult church oftentimes. And so there's this kind of empty space where they're finding themselves, which is what they're doing anyway. So I have some support for this talk from a couple of sources. My first is Pema Chodron. I hope that you are familiar with her. She is a deep bodhicitta. That is, she is devoted to bringing loving kindness to the planet at this time. And so that will be coming from her book that's called The Places That Scare You, A Guide to Fearlessness in Difficult Times. And you might find yourself today in a difficult time. You might find yourself tomorrow in a difficult time. And there's always a resource that we have that will transmute or transform that. I'm also going to use what we call the big book, our science of mind, and see what Ernest Holmes has to say about that. And when I was thinking about loving kindness and the meditation, I had to go there, because one of the things that I thought about, and you might as well, is the two great commandments that are found in our Christian teachings, which are vast in this country, to love God with all of your heart and soul and mind. And then the second is to love your neighbor as yourself. And these two are equated as being equal in weight. So I wanted to explore that a little bit with our loving kindness, because Pema tells us the very first step in a loving kindness meditation, if you've never done one, there's seven steps, and we start with ourselves. We start here, because we can't really do anything for anybody else if we don't have it here first. We're giving from an empty bucket, right? So we start with ourselves. And this is what she says about, in cultivating loving kindness, we train first to be honest, loving, and compassionate towards ourselves. The instruction for cultivating limitless maitri, which is loving kindness, is to first find the tenderness that we already have. We touch it with our gratitude and our appreciation. And there's a little bit more guidance in this, because sometimes we might not find it easy to do this. And so she gives us a little bit of help here. She says, whether we find this tenderness in the feeling of love, or the vulnerability of feeling lonely, is immaterial. That tenderness exists everywhere. It is in that vulnerability. It is in that soft heart. It is in when our heart is so overflowing that the tears come from our eyes, from either sadness or from love. We are tender beings. And so we're going to tap into that in order to give that back. She says the first step in cultivating loving kindness is to see where and when we are erecting barriers between ourselves and others. So I'm curious, with that instruction, where, and I'd like you to just express it, just give a shout out, where do you find yourself erecting a barrier between yourself and others? There might be times, there might be people, there might be circumstances, situations. Where do you find yourself erecting a barrier?
Politics.
Right up there.
Judgmental.
Yes, judgment. That's a barrier. Right up. Yes, we have to protect ourselves. Put that barrier up. The language that we use, and she gives instruction. I don't claim to be a Buddhist, but the instructions are very clear about our language and our speech and what is right speech and what is loving speech. So if you want to know more about that, it's in here too. It's in many places. It's the foundation. Making yourself a wallflower is creating a barrier between yourself and others. And there's a reason that you do that, right? Some part of you, that tender spot, is being touched. You go, oh, Jim.
Playing exactly on that and developing and cultivating my own spiritual practices. It's a very tender,
yeah,
special place, and sometimes it's hard to walk out into the general public without some form of
confession. Yes, because when we've got ourselves so deep into love, and our heart is so, so open, like, my gosh, then you are like undefended. But in practicing loving kindness, we can walk out into the world and we can see those circumstances and we can listen to the news and we can do these things and we can hear what people are saying with that open heart. We don't have to be defended. We can go about the world undefended. This was one of my goals, I think it was last year, is to be undefended in my life. I don't have to defend myself. Yes, right? Yeah. Unity. There's only one thing happening. There's only one thing happening, and that's life. It just happens to happen differently for each of us. We just express it differently. But in terms of ego, comparison, right? That judgment. We're all just doing this thing. And this is a practice that helps us do it in a loving way, that nurtures that tender, open-hearted vulnerability in a way that we feel safe with. And so we'll talk a little bit more about safety. I want to reach back into that idea of taking care of the self, this I, me first. But that's where we are. Like, we are in this I body, we're in this me. This is what we're doing. We aren't anybody else in the sense that we have an individual identification. And so Ernest Holmes, and I thought immediately of the two great commandments, love God with all of your heart and your, let me see, what does he say? Here's what Ernest Holmes says, and this is from the teachings of Jesus in the big book, page 459, the two great commandments from Matthew 22, 36 through 41. The two great commandments are to love God and our brother man. On these hang all the law and the prophets. Love is a complete unity with life, and we cannot enter this state unless we are in unity with all that lives, for all life is one. To love God alone is not enough, for this would exclude our fellow man. To love our fellow man alone is not sufficient, for this would be too limited a concept of God. When we realize that God and man are one and not two, we shall love both. We shall love man as an expression of God and God as the life principle in all. From this teaching, we are not to suppose that we are to love that in each other which does not savor of right. I'm going to read that again. We are not to suppose that we are to love that in each other which does not savor of right. We are to love the right alone. We are to look for God in each other and love this God, forgetting all else. But would this compel us to accept from people that which is not good? Of course not. It is not necessary for one to make a doormat of himself in proving that God is love. It is not necessary for one to make himself a doormat in proving that God is love, for this would be like suffering for righteousness' sake, which is always a mistake. So loving kindness is all about loving self and loving other. And so, as I said, it's a seven-step process. We begin with ourselves, and I'll walk us through that. And then we move on to a loved one. And then we move on to somebody who maybe is less than that lovely one. Then there's somebody who is absolutely neutral to us. We don't know them. They're just neutral to us. And then we move into the more difficult of individuals. And she has some guidance on this as well. Oh, and I didn't mark the page. The fifth step is to work with a difficult person, someone we find irritating. When we see this person, we armor our heart. Again, put that block between us. We armor our heart. I know we all know what that means. I know we all know what that means. So she says it's best, at least in the beginning, if you haven't done this before, at least in the beginning, not to practice with our heaviest relationship. So it would be with somebody who's just an irritant, who you find it hard maybe to love or to see that God within. We don't want to feel overwhelmed. And for those of us who have been practitioners of loving kindness meditation, we might go right there. we might go for it and find that individual or individuals. And for myself as well, oftentimes the direction is to find an individual. If you find yourself bringing to mind more than one individual, that's perfectly fine. The structure isn't fixed. There's a lot of flexibility, and it's you that gets to decide how we do this. I will give you a phrase, but you can, and there's going to be plenty of time, so you have time to play with the phrasing, to play with the feeling, to see what's happening in your heart. Do you feel like that shield, that barrier is coming up? And so repeating to yourself over and over again the phrasing. She says we can spend as much time as we want with each stage and not criticizing ourselves if we sometimes find it artificial or contrived. So I'm going to sit down, and we're going to do a loving kindness meditation. So I'd ask you to just find a comfortable seat. Oftentimes the guidance is to push yourself back in your seat, and that kind of lifts your back off of the back of your chair. Instead of being in this kind of posture, you're more alert and ready and heart forward if you're sitting forward. Take a moment to breathe. And to be present to where it is we are and what it is that we're doing today. What are we doing here? Why did we come here? What are we doing? What has already resonated for you this morning? So as we begin, we cultivate that open-hearted tenderness, that willingness, that vulnerability, and love for self. And if we need help in finding love for self, or that feeling of love, you might find it with a memory. You might think of a person. You might think of an event. Anything that brings to you a sense of deep joy and love and gratitude and appreciation for life. Just allow yourself to remember, to cultivate that feeling that there is good in this world. I'm going to use the gong a little bit. The bell, the chime, the gong, that resonance is a call to come home. It's a call to come back to ourselves. So we'll take a moment to bring all those pieces that we've left behind, that we've given away. I'm just going to call everything home. So take a breath. One more. And say to yourself, may I be well. May I be happy. And may I be free from suffering. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be free from suffering. Just allowing that feeling of love and well-being to emanate from within and extend itself out. That there is a great vibration and feeling of well-being and loving kindness that emanates from me right here, right now. Invite into your consciousness, into your awareness, into that inner vision, somebody who you love deeply. It might be more than one person. You might have a crowd. But if you could choose one, is there somebody who needs it particularly right now? Say this to them. May you be well. May you be happy. May you be free from suffering. May you be well. May you be happy. May you be free from suffering.
feel that, that vibration, that sense of well-being extending beyond yourself to include this person or persons. And now bring to your mind's eye, bring in front of you a friend who your relationship is a little more complicated. And with a deep breath and with that heightened vibration of loving kindness, say to this person or persons, may you be well. May you be happy. May you be free from suffering. May you be well. May you be happy. May you be free from suffering. Allowing for that vibration, a resonance of well-being that extends beyond yourself to include this person or persons. Deeply connected, may you be well. May you be happy, and may you be free from suffering. Take a deep breath and feel the resonance of that. It's a transmission of love. And so now we invite an individual who is neutral to us, somebody that we encounter but don't really know. May you be well. May you be happy. And may you be free from suffering. May you be well. May you be happy. And may you be free from suffering. Take a deep breath into that resonance. Loving kindness. It includes this individual. Having gathered all this loving kindness, all this well-being, having extended it beyond ourselves, bring to your mind that difficult person. Look at this person and recognizing we are all one. There's only one thing happening. It's all God. Say to this person or persons, May you be well. May you be happy. And may you be free from suffering. And say it as many times as you need to, until you truly mean it and you feel yourself leaning into the words. May you be well. May you be happy. And may you be free from suffering. So now you have this group of vibrating, shining individuals whom you hold in this orb of loving kindness. And so this next piece is a complete dissolving of barriers. As we visualize ourselves, our beloved, our friend, the neutral person, and that difficult one, all standing in front of us. We breathe and we connect with that feeling of kind heart for all of these individuals at once. Beaming, radiating, vibrating, loving kindness. And at this point we say, may we all be well. May we all be happy. And may we all be free from suffering. May we all be well. May we all be happy. May we all be free from suffering. 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 May we all be free. May we all be free. May we all be free. In the final step, is to have our circle now radiating out this loving kindness to the entire universe. We expand our loving kindness to all beings everywhere. Neighborhood, city, nation, universe. And we stand together and we say, may all beings everywhere be well. May all beings everywhere be happy. May all beings everywhere be free from suffering. May all beings everywhere be happy, be well, be free from suffering. Thank you. We just let this feeling ride, flow. So if we just take a deep breath together. And one more. One more. Pema says the main point of doing this practice is to uncover the ability to love without bias. Making these aspirations is like watering the seed of goodwill so it begins to grow. In the course of doing this, we'll become acquainted with our barriers, our numbness, our inadequacies, our skepticism, our resentments, our righteous indignation, our pride, and all the others. As we continue to do this practice, we make friends with our fears, our grasping, and our aversions. Unconditional good heart towards others is not even a possibility unless we attend to our own demons. Why we begin with ourselves. Everything we encounter thus becomes an opportunity for practicing loving kindness. And so with that, I want to encourage you to pick up your prayer card. And if you feel called, you can write out a demonstration, which is that building of faith. You've done it before. It's happened before. We can do it again. It can happen again. Or just make your prayer request. And we will have another song from Becky and Matt.
Secrets down at the cross, at the cross.
on the other side.
So much, Matt and Becky, that was awesome. Appreciate it. And I just wanted to say once again, Karen, we could all just give Karen let's just give Karen a round of applause. This was done on less than 24 hours notice, so thank you so much. That was very much a blessing. Thank you so much. That felt so good. I don't know how it felt for all of you, but that felt so great for me to be able to extend that and have that inside myself. So thank you so much for that blessing. So right now we know that our center is supported by God, and we welcome you to be a part of how God's support shows up. If you are on Facebook, please can visit our website at genesiscsl.org, or you can text your tithe to 206-800-7595. Let us take a moment to craft our financial gift. Together. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, all that I receive, and I am thankful. And now, Giddy, you want to get up and come around and collect our offering as we sing God is my source.
God is my source. God is my power. God gives me everything I need. So I give thanks for all my blessings. God gives me everything I need. God is my source. God is my power. God gives me everything I need. So I give thanks.
Receive tenfold. In deep gratitude, we give thanks, and so it is. Thank you all for joining us today. Let us stand and sing our closing song, I Release.